everybody, welcome back to Northernlion Plays The Binding of Isaac. Antibirth, where we won last time. Pretty easily, actually, as well. Ooh, the miter and the pony. E8R1FE48. Bit dicey. Low on HP. It's not the pony, it's the white pony. Low on HP, low on damage, rate of fire is terrible. Full health, amazing. And yet, at the same time, I feel somewhat confident on this run. Because we can fly, that doesn't necessarily help too much. Oh god, but because we can fly, and because, the miter is actually excellent, but we do need it to pay out. We're gonna need DPS pretty soon on this one to make it happen, but I have the utmost faith in our ability to do so. I see a tinted rock, we need a bomb. Not what I really wanted, another finger curls on the monkey's paw, I suppose. I just hate, like, it taking 10 shots to kill every enemy. Please. I'm begging you. There we go. We got our bomb. Just live through this room. Excuse me? Okay, live through as many rooms. I'm going to rephrase. Live through as many rooms as is necessary to live through in order to get back where you want to go here. I was thinking about maybe I could be a smart guy who's actually kind of a stupid guy and use those, bombs to possibly find the secret room. It's too dicey. But my heart was in the right place. Canadian accent coming out strong there. We did excellently with that tinted rock. Unfortunately, it's kind of not the right time. You know, it's like getting your college tuition paid for when you're 80. It's just not the right time. Who do we have here though? Famine? That's not bad. It would have been nice to actually hit with any of our beams of light there, but so be it, you know, you can't always get what you want. We will probably not get HP for this, we will get a cube of meat or a ball of bandages, either of which is completely, utterly okay. However, being one hit away from death is not where I want to be here, especially because we do have the alt path opened up to us, like, immediately, and, I mean, do I look like some kind of, you know, cowardly dog named ironically after the virtue of, you know, being honorable? Do I look like Courage the Cowardly Dog is what I'm trying to suggest? I'm gonna go to the alt path. The only thing is, we need to know the alternate path is gonna be difficult. So after knowing that, what's the next step? Well, I guess preparing yourself for having to actually deal with it. We can go into the curse room. Is it a good idea? I'd say there's like a 40% chance that it could be a pretty good idea. Black hearts, spirit hearts, red hearts, I guess, if you get like a regular chest inside of a red chest or something. Teleportations to the deal with the devil, 9 lives. Like, there's some outcomes. There's more than no outcomes where we can get something of value out of it. I think I will probably check it now, honestly. I regret nothing yet. Baby, I regret nothing yet. Here's something that you're probably gonna regret. Okay, you get the idea. Full health. It's not what we were looking for, but we tried. We'll head down to our next floor. At least we have a charge ready, but, you know, there's plenty of enemies down here that deal one hit, and I would be frightened to have to deal with them. Luckily, we may not have to, depending on how quickly we can pick up a spirit heart or something like it. Thank God for the small rock. Like, 4.69 damage is great. Our rate of fire is still garbage, but 4.69 damage at least means that despite our rate of fire being garbage, our DPS is at least acceptable. Certainly not good. I mean, Loki's horns didn't do us many favors on the last floor either, but that's what this item room is for now. I would love to honestly get an item that gave us a spirit heart, but any stats are gonna be useful as... this is a tough decision, dude, because first off, I've just started going through puberty again. Secondly, I mean, Forget Me Now actually gives us a leg up on the competition. You know, we can get a lot of value out of Forget Me Now. The problem is, I don't want to lose the ability to fly, which is one of the few things probably keeping me alive right now. But my value-oriented Isaac brain, it won't allow me to not take forget-me-now, especially when we finish this room, which is going to take 2,000 or 3,000 years. Any chance you could just blow yourself up? You think we could sing the entirety of Walk the Dinosaur before we finish this room? It was a night like this 40 million years ago. I lit a cigarette, picked up a monkey skull to go. Alright, ooh, bombs. Okay, the answer is no, we could not sing the entirety of Everybody Walk the Dinosaur on that room. That's ridiculous. Free access to the curse room, please. Free access to the secret room, please. Okay. Red hearts. We live another floor. Well, our deal with the devil odds are not good here. So, what I'm thinking right now is, you know, full on, we do these things not because they are easy, but because they are hard meta. Which is to say that, I would very much like... Jesus, just fart off for a second. Whoa! Is one enemy dead? Come on. Is to say that I would very much like to do this entire floor, forget me now, and then do it again. But it's gonna cost us the ability to fly. I'm not saying we need to get the ability to fly to make it worthwhile, but, you know, if you're offering, I wouldn't kick it out of bed for eating crackers, if you know what I mean. I don't really know what that means, but we've discussed the etymology of that idiom many times on the show in the past, and I don't necessarily want to belabor the point unnecessarily, so here we go. Okay, you know, honestly, Vanessa, it's not mine, but we also have, just gonna say, the chance to maybe go to our shop and get something good. But here's the catch. We can't really take advantage of that, because we're gonna use Forget Me Now. Or are we? I don't know. I mean, the shears is great as well. We've got too many good active items to choose from here. I'm gonna go to our curse room. We've already taken a hit, so the deal with the devil chance is low. Now watch it give me like Guppy's head or something. We don't need bombs right now. This moment could have like incredible impact on the remainder of this run. Oh, you fucker. Okay. I think we kill the boss, take our, you know, D3 reroll on it, or roll on a chance with a deal with the devil. Oh my god, if only I could hit with a single one of these. Oh, that's right, the white pony is still kind of bad because there was a buff for crack the sky effects that happens in Afterbirth. But we're still on Rebirth, so anything with Crack the Sky is actually kind of not good right now, right? Or at least could be better. We expect it to be better. Easy fight, at least. Always happy with that one. Did get a deal with the devil. Okay, blood clot. And then it shouldn't kill me. We should get the spirit heart. We got the spirit heart. Okay. What do you do now? That's a great question. I'm glad you asked. I think you use the forget me now. Our speed is going to be horrible. And this is like, it's a move that could kill us, but it's also a move that could set us truly free. Oh, we are way slower than I anticipated. Blood clot, not that amazing. The pact, fantastic, obviously. Or perhaps obviously. Apparently, that's maybe a better way to describe it. Certainly looking for HP and speed. Those are the big ones right now. Okay. Undefined. I don't love it, but I do need a spacebar item. And I think you can do worse than having teleports, at least. But certainly, what frightens me the most right now is this idea that we only have one spirit heart? I mean, what'd you expect me to say? We're so slow, the flies don't even, like, move around us properly. You think we could sing the entirety of Walk the Dinosaur before we finish this room? Yeah! No! That run sucked, dude. 88A01QZC. Could have won if we just stuck it out with the white pony, maybe, but how could I not, right? So this run we got Boiled Baby. I think that item is great. Then we got Cricket's Body now, which is good. Damage is 4.11. Rate of fire is exceptionally fast. It's not the best run to start with, but it's really good. We got Book of Sin along with it as well. So this is like, I would stop short of calling it a guaranteed win, but I really feel like Boiled Baby is one of those items that, at least, I won't speak for other people, but I, you know, look at a familiar most of the time and go, don't expect it to be that useful, right? I disagree with that assessment right now. Like, Boiled Baby, at least when it hits, is extremely good. Amnesia, on the other hand, not that excited by it. We figured that was probably guaranteed to be a library back there. We have no keys. Now that we have one key, that's going to be our alt path enabler. Now we have two keys. We could try to open that, but it's a little too wishful thinking, I think. So let's come back. Open this up. It's not a library, but it is many cards. Okay. Yara's great, so we'll roll with that, but we're going to use the Joker first. And this may kill us, but I'm going to take it nonetheless. There we go. So I actually thought that that might be the case, that it would just leave us on zero HP. So I'm not content with your normal human runs. You can't handle my zaniest runs. My zaniest runs would kill even a speedrunner. YouTube streamer. I am going on a public transportation trip. I need your zaniest runs. You can't handle my zaniest runs. My zaniest runs would make even the most level-headed... Let me try that again. My zaniest runs would make even the most level-headed viewer become an angry commenter. Even the sanest, most cool-headed individual amongst you would leave a dislike. You can't handle my zaniest runs, traveler. Okay, this is just getting annoying. Alright, I went for the golden chest instead of the shop. You're a rascal. You're a rascal, Northern Lion. All credit for that goes to Potion Seller Guy. A true comedic genius. Without whom, this video could not exist. Hey, how about you fuck off? Oh god, it almost got me. Alright, so what's the play? Well, I mean, I'd really like this guy to drop some HP. We're good. Okay, thank you, Boiled Baby. Boiled Baby with the kill shot. Yes! Super Bandage has saved us from the nothing we've become, and we'll head downwards. Alright, that pretty much killed my throat to do the Potion Seller voice. So I'm happy to be moving along. Keeping it a little bit more low-key here. That's how you know we're getting to the end of the recording day, when we start to bust out stuff like that. How's this run? It's extremely, also very good right now, actually. Like, as compared to our last run, we're better in, like, every avenue. Including the area I've rocked down to, which is Electric Avenue, and wanna take you higher. Thank God we got some compensation for that damage. I freaking hate these guys, man. Don't shoot at me with your incredibly long-range shots, you snipers. Okay, we're gonna take the D6, which is lovely. And then, you know what? It's not good, but we're gonna take it because now we got Loki's horns again. It's not as bad as it was in our last round because we have Cricket's Body along with it, but certainly it's not great. But, you know, it provides a nice little duality with our last run, so I will run along with it. Now all we need is Small Rock, which we didn't get. Instead, we got two completely extremely important Spirit Hearts, which will allow us to feel somewhat safe after we take our deal with the devil here. Which we're guaranteed to at least see. Oh, what the hell, dude? Spawned right on top of me. Goddamn alligator struck me down in my prime. Probably we're rushing a little bit right now. J.K. Simmons would be like mega pissed. Not a whole lot of room to travel down here. I would advise myself to maybe not make that same move. Next time, experimental treatment a little dangerous. Oh, come on. I mean, we have to take it because it's still a pretty good deal here, but I still take experimental treatment even though it doesn't give us spun. And wow, give us a damage downgrade. All other stats except for tears went up, aka all the other stats that are irrelevant from a DPS standpoint. Curse of the Giant. Still, I stand by that. Gimpy's a great pickup. I wish it didn't cost us Spirit Hearts. What the fuck happened there? I actually am mad about that one. And I don't get mad very often. I didn't go to the item room on the last floor? No, I got Loki's horns. What are you talking about here? Mercurius, speed up, plus you feel elusive. First off, we look badass as well. And we get a chaos card. We should use our Yera. If we find a spot on this floor to use Yera, take advantage of it. I think, here's what I think happened on that room. Those enemies spawned, and they have like a pretty quick acceleration to them, you know? I think maybe just before they spawned, one of our Cricket's body shots came out and like landed behind them, and then the explosion of the shot kind of propelled them out with an impressive pace that led to me getting hit. We actually got pretty freaking lucky that we didn't get destroyed more easily there. So as far as I'm concerned, a chaos card is something. Well, we could use it on Great Gideon. Apparently there's like an achievement for that or something. But don't forget the knife piece or the item room. Knife piece. Let's go to the item room first. Taking a little bit of damage thus far that feels mysterious. Okay, there's item room and shop, okay. I'm still perturbed by part of the situation as it stands, but that's life, man. That's freaking life. Life is about getting perturbed and not letting it tilt you beyond the point of recovery. Number one life skill you can have, A, properly naming your variables and functions in your program. B, not getting tilted. Bad trip, you would tilt me like that as I'm talking about not getting tilted? Makes me look like a dang hypocrite. We made it. Okay, oh, epic fetus. It does not suck. And if you want to talk about, NL, you should not take epic fetus. Why don't you take a look at what the game freaking did to me, buddy? Before you get on my case about taking Epic Fetus here. Just wanted to see if there was anything worth going like super hard for there. Yera? I mean, we're wasting the Yera rune, but I sort of don't care. That is the secret room. The game has been giving bad trip pill. Go fudge yourself pill. I don't appreciate it. It's vulgarity. Loki's horn is always a little tricky. We should have at least used Yera to doubles our money, but... I ain't about living that lifestyle. How did we not get hit there? Thank you. Thank you for popping back up like that. One more. Ah! Get him! He's dead. He's not dead, so we have to go through this bullshit. Just don't hit yourself. Here we go. Oh! Gets me every time. Okay, that's good though. Latch key gives us a spirit heart, gives us some keys. Let's move onwards here. Got a lock upgrade as well. Headed down to the mines and honestly not feeling super enthusiastic about our chances. I mean, I am feeling enthusiastic about our chances. What's making me feel slightly less enthusiastic is our relative chances compared to the average Epic Fetus run. Obviously, on this run, we're looking pretty good. It's just on a normal Epic Fetus run, you're like, eh, we're probably like 90% favorites to win. Right now, I feel like we're like 65% favorites to win. Little bit more HP. Go a long way. A way to constantly replenish our HP would go a long way, but hey, that's what the D6 is for, is to create something out of nothing. get us started on that track. And again, the game pulls no punches. At least right now, I feel like me and the game are pretty evenly matched, you know? Can't be batting much over 50%, even if we're even over 50%. So if the game gives me Epic Fetus and D6, I'm taking it. And I'm not complaining too much. That's not so bad. That's not so bad. Crack that open. Okay. Blow this guy up for the devil deal chance. Another 5%. Nothing wrong with that. I don't think we were gaining very much out of our, trinket there. I appreciate the spirit heart. I will take the compass. This guy should not give us an extra bonus, but yeah. Take the compass. It's fine by me. Donation machine could use a little work, but no big concerns. Great Gideon, I'm just gonna chaos him. He's dead, okay. Apparently that opens up some kind of special achievement. Unlocks something? I don't know. It looks pretty cool at least. I don't know, outside of here is a speed upgrade? I stand by this decision. Not that one, though. I'm not gonna take that. There might be a battery charge we can find, so let's not speed up, or let's not, just leave this floor right now. Try to gain some money, maybe get a reroll charge, be set up wisely here. This is only mines one, so we got plenty of time left to accomplish things. If they'll let me back in, I'll probably take Guppy's head now, but, we don't really care about that. We should remember that we have, Epic Fetus. So what are we looking for? Cool tier effects like Sad Bombs or, you know, Brimstone or anything along those lines. But, really, HP is king. Damage is nice, but Jesus Juice is not really worth going for. We're gonna be a little bit more discerning in what we want to take. Didn't get him. Got him. Okay, probably Virgo over Abel, because I'm, you know, this isn't my first time playing this game, and, we'll go crack into this, and back up at 4 cents here, and we'll just go, honestly, like, might be nice to have 5 cents for the next floor, but I think we're relatively happy. We will take Jesus Juice, and then, ooh, wait a minute, what's going on over here? What? Thank you, Boil Baby. Thank you, Boil Baby, for your help. So this is, I mean, super weird, but also really cool. Brainworm and Ouija board do nothing for us, but I am stoked. Chaos card opens up a weird little catacomb underneath Great Gideon. And we'll head down to the next floor. Nothing wrong with this. And we did get to arcade levels, at least. It's bats, right? No, nope, just nothing. This is nothing. Inside of our shop. I was hoping that there would be, like, a bed or something in there. I don't know, dude. Shops are weird. I always want a blood bank. They've rarely given me one these days, it seems like, but who am I to complain? More deal with the devil chance. Only 2% bonus here, but it's something. This is the mines, too. So we definitely need the knife piece. So let's just nip that in the bud and make sure we're backtracking as much as may seem appropriate, although I did just hit myself there. Now we are out a chaos card, but well, we're out a Yara rune and a chaos card, I guess, if you want to get technical, but I did that on purpose. I hope that that's clear. I wanted, people told me to do it. People told me there was something cool in there, and you know what? There was. I don't regret our decision, although I might if we find ourselves dying to the second phase of the witness. We're probably not going to get into, boss rush. Help me. How did I open the door while there's still a unit alive? That was weird. I think it's a rerollable situation. Ah, fuck it, let's do it. I'm ready. What did we do there? We got Pyro. We're extremely slow. We have Cursed Eye. But Bloody Lust. We need these Spirit Hearts to make it to the next floor. Yes, my best friend. You're saving my life. Thank you so much for your support. Do we know what this is? I do not. Telepills. Again, boss rush interests me not. Instead, we're going a full-on, like, Rebirth era zany run with a D4. Who would have thought? I don't really want to go fight. Well, what are our bombs like? Just regular old bombs. Okay. I don't really want to fight our boss like this. And we do need our knife piece, so slow down. Unless we rerolled. No, we still got the handle. Small rock, please. Fucking spider rocks, dude. Yep. I have turdy touch, so that's interesting, although probably not really that likely to be useful. Oh, we have Taurus as well. This is like a recurring theme. Okay, now we just want to get great speed. Because, like, Taurus, great speed, and turdy touch would be like a recipe to kill every enemy very easily. It's actually not half bad as far as runs go. You know, considering we have 99 bombs, especially, like, we have the chance to keep ourselves alive until something happens that takes this run over to the next level. Basically, a speed upgrade? Ooh, tears down. That's not the end of the world, but pretty bad. That's all right. Let's reroll it. Halo. Now we have Midas Touch. We're very small. We have Little Brimstone. PhD, maybe? Yeah, PhD. We are so fast now that I'm actually mad. Because if we had that on our last run, that would have been beautiful. This might be something to stick with here. What's our damage stat? 4.69, good rate of fire. Okay, yeah. I'm going to roll with this as our run then, because it's kind of ridiculous. We got our knife piece. Not necessarily think. Did he just give us double middle fingers? Not the greatest run from a damage standpoint. Like, do we have a negative damage multiplier somewhere? Because it seems like we should be doing more. We're very tiny and very fast. This run is also very loud right now. Oh, we got, like, Virgo invincibility or something? Trying to find the right cadence at which to place bombs in order to make sure they home in on the right enemy. Yeah, that makes sense. They did it! Okay, one bomb is so valuable here. No, I knocked it away. Or did I? Did I? Oh, we got it. Okay, so we got two bombs. No deal with the devil. I don't know. Like, this seems pretty okay. Wait, where's our other knife piece? We only have one knife piece now. Well, okay. I mean, I got two knife pieces, so I'm a little unhappy about it, but... Ooh, money equals power for sure. Well, I guess that means we'll just have to get Mom's Knife if we want to do the alt path and be the half-decent deal-with-the-devil chance this time. You know, there's a beyond-theoretical chance that could happen here, so... Should probably just use, like, one bomb per room. There might not even be 92 rooms over the rest of the game, so... I mean, there's a temptation to pick up that stuff, without a doubt, but... I sort of want to shy away from it right now because we have such a good damage stat, pretty much like 100% as a result of the fact that our money is great. The rest of our stats are kind of like underwhelming, so. You cannot hit my bombs away. You're just, you know, bouncing them back and forth. Bothers me very little. That was a really good shot. Can't even be mad, honestly. Don't really want that. Okay, so we're really leaning on the opportunity to have a deal with the devil here. Like, that's a big part of my chances for success. Also, like, not walking into every single enemy that exists would be helpful as well. But I know better than to promise you the moon here. I could promise you the moon card. Probably will go to the curse room. Although this floor, oh God, is hard. It's not doing double damage yet, so. Let's try not to overstate its difficulty right now. I do want to check out these rooms back here. Okay, this is actually a dead end. So the other rooms are separated by teleporter. I do want the virus, though. I think it's good enough. I forgot that it gives you a speed downgrade, but honestly, that might be like a blessing in disguise right now. Yeah, okay, I'm confused. You've sufficiently confused me. I became confused a couple of times there. How is our damage so bad? It feels like half my shots aren't hitting or something. I know that's ridiculous, but I'm very confused as to why, you know, the stats look good. But then when I'm actually, like, on a fight, they're not getting the job done. Maybe I'm just missing a lot and, you know, trying to overcompensate with Blue Baby's only friend or something. Bosses on this floor, they tend to be rough, but excuse me. Never tell me the odds, unless they're in my favor. In which case, you know, tell me the odds on the regular. I like to be the favorite, if possible. Being the underdog, you know, it's too easy. Everybody wants you to win. Winning is the favorite, is the real. I'll take villainous things to say. This guy doesn't like underdogs. Get him! Okay. We got two yuck hearts. I'm happy with the flies. I'm happy with the spirit hearts. The visage. This is where we're actually going to be really happy to have Little Brim to break that chain. We fought the visage like two runs ago. And it took us maybe 400 to 500 years to break that chain. Oh my god! I don't think I've ever been hit by that. That's a cool attack. I mean, it's just a cool boss in general when it doesn't die in 2 seconds. I don't really know what to do to increase our kill rate here, but it's working. Alright, we did it. I guess we'll take HP. Head down to the next floor. Okay. I'm concerned is a fair word. Curse of the Giant. I feel like we should be doing a lot better. Maybe that's on me. But I can't shake the feeling that, like, the stat screen is kind of lying to me. So Scapular's great, but I'm going to take Mysterious Liquid. I think it synergizes very nicely with Cricket's body. And sure, lots more money. 0.27 damage increase. Nothing to sneeze at. Well, how many cents did we pick up? How could you get to 0.27 by multiplying 4? You can get to 0.28. You pick up 7 cents. Does that mean we have like a 75% damage multiplier? Maybe we got a skinny odd mushroom somewhere in here? I don't know, but I mean, if I wanted to solve this mystery, I could just look in the, you know, the pause screen at the items that we've got, but you know I'm not going to do that, so let's not kid ourselves. Except now I am. I'm looking for, like, soy milk or something. There's a can, but I'm pretty sure that's food. Yeah, they're both food. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really know, to be honest with you. Hangman. I think the conclusion I'm drawing is that I'm just, I'm overthinking it. Two more keys. Yeah, we'll go back. I don't know if we should pick up a knife piece. I'm serious when I said that, like, we might as well just try to get Mom's knife. So we'll start with our, devil room. After that, we'll also finish with our devil room because we've already been to the item room. It's really our only chance for that, I think. Because there's no chaos in the game. I mean, there's chaos, but there's no capital C chaos, you know, a proper noun item. I would describe this run as a little chaotic, though. That's our friend. All right. This is our room right here. The last room of any relevancy. Theirs options can still give us, like, one... Maybe more boss fights because, oh, I didn't mean to buy that. Maybe more boss fights of usefulness because of the fact that, we might not be going to the alt path. I would say we probably won't be going to the alt path. So we spent a lot of money there. But our damage kind of sucks regardless. We were predominantly using, like, Little Brim. So the damage downgrade is a bummer. But I think to have a reroll ready for our 100% devil deal is pretty valuable. It's gonna shoot! I think, although I'm complaining a lot about not getting hit, I'm honestly just absurdly lucky to not get hit. Oh, right, I forgot we had minus touch. There's been a lot of situations where it really feels like I should be taking damage, but somehow, like, we're evading it. I don't know if that's that, like, I feel evasive thing we got earlier, because we've rerolled our whole run since then, so I don't know if that's pervasive or what. We're gonna take the Polaroid. Invincibility would really help us with Midas Touch. And you know what? Don't hate me for this. Even if it's Lump of Coal, we're gonna reroll it, because we need Mom's Knife to open that door. Beautiful. Brother Bobby, just a great item. All right. Now we have no knife pieces as well. Now the most Northern Lion thing would be if we actually had that knife piece all the time and it just got it got lost in the shuffle, like a familiar was holding it or something. That happens. I will accept that as being, you know, well within the bounds of my own idiocy. To be honest with you, not being forced to go the alt path route seems like it might be a blessing in disguise for this run right now anyway. Come on. Come on, dude. There we go. We have a boss trap room. We have a curse room. I think we're on zero guppy items unless we rerolled into one, maybe? So... being on zero guppy items means I don't really care. About going to the curse room. I do care about our devil deal chance, though. I care deeply about that. I also love the fact that, good lord, we've been insanely lucky to continue to have, these yuck hearts here. Hopefully we don't lose them, like, immediately right now. Bombs are key. I don't know. I think I prefer having this many bombs. Oh, right, we're already on the womb, too. I always forget that when you get shafted out of the alt path, you come down to the womb, too. It's where they, like, recover one of the floors. So what's the ticket here? Drop bombs. This dude is just farting all over the place. Thank God we don't have smell-o-vision yet. It's in the HTC Vive version, the Binding of Vivezik. There's a better joke in there somewhere. Lord knows I can't find it. We can already fly. I don't really care about spectral tears, so... I don't believe that spectral tears are what we need right now to save this run. All the items here forthwith are useful. If we lose now, this run will be a snoozeful. There are synergies that I would like to get for you, but... I mean, how? Blue baby, you're gonna be the boss that slays me. 'Cause after all... on the chest, they're gonna give us Pokeball. Something like that, you know? Zipblue baby, you're gonna be the boss that slays me. There's something in there. It started terribly. Oh, get that back. But, I think we redeemed ourselves ever so slightly by the end of it. That's my secret to improv. Not that I know, like, really anything about it. But, you know, give yourself permission to suck really badly about 90% of the way through a joke, Because if you can make the final 10% happen, that's all people are going to remember. So, I mean, obviously the yuck hearts are pretty important right now. We're looking for like an emperor card. Honestly, I think the world card is close to as good as the emperor. Just as a means for us to finish the chest as fast as possible, not because we're tight on time, but because we're a little low on the resource of HP, so. Okay, that was actually a pretty good start to this fight, honestly. Okay, that one, it hit me in the blind spot. Probably hit me, like, right in the center of my face, but my peripheral vision IRL. Oh, right, okay, you have invincibility. Occasionally, thanks to Virgo or Celtic Cross, so. Anytime you get hit, you should look for it, even though you're, like, mad tiny. And, hopefully, you will be able to do so much damage with Midas Touch that it's gonna ruin his life. Back. 52 cents. I would love to, you know, nearly double that. The odds of that, fairly low. Unless, you know what? Unicorn Stump. That's our ticket. I've been not at all harping on Midas Touch, occasionally remembering that we have it, but to get Unicorn Stump would save the day. All right, let's think about this critically. We got 99 bombs. I think you take that, reroll everything else. Shoop the whoop. Still kind of bad. 9 volts plus Book of Shadows, though, is a huge get. This is basically invincibility. Invincibility is damage and money. Plus, we get to use it once every 2 rooms. Do we not have Midas Touch? Am I losing my mind? Maybe it just has to be saved for, like, a more sensible room? I don't know, dude. Like, walk into this guy. Oh, we're just so tiny that it's tough to freeze an enemy with Midas Touch because our hitbox is so small. Well, it's not popping off as much as I'd like, but it is capable of doing good damage. This is more of your Midas Touch room, honestly, but we want to not just run into enemies because we need to keep these yuck hearts alive. Similarly, on this room, we're happy to just move on. Okay, let's do it, dude. Bombs are very, very decent right now. We're gonna win. This is a weird run. I mean, not least of which of its issues was the very bizarre use of D4. But here we are. Probably coming through with a victory. There we go. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like. There we go. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.